So I'm a land defender, and for the last 2 years I've been going to indigenous camps like Maddie Lee and Voice for the Voiceless camp. And I've seen indigenous people defend their land against corporate extraction processes. And what I feel is the reason why our campaign didn't work is because at the Twist and Shout Forest, the message wasn't that it was indigenous land. The message was that they were protesting and they wanted to stop it. But I believe that when the evidence is gathered for an injunction, if the only message is that it's native land and that they don't have permission to be there, I don't believe that the courts would want to dispute that. And that's how Unistoten is still there 5 years later, stopping all like 5 different pipelines from entering their land. Thank you.